Roar! Or whatever.
Hey Dino fans, D-Rex here. And today I'm skipping over 10 other things that I need to open because last weekend I was lucky enough to find these. And the way that I did it was I went to a Walmart that I never go to, that was right off the interstate, that's, you know, I don't ever go to it because there's nothing else around it and it's way out of the way, but timing it, it's really only about 20-minute drive up the interstate from where I normally go check for things. So for me, it paid off to take the risk to drive the extra 20 minutes because I found the Tapejara and the Dimetrodon. Now, the Tapejara is cool, but the Dimetrodon is one of, like, the most important toys in the entire line for me to have. I personally have this thing about Dimetrodon, and I will tell you why. This little pink guy right here is my first quote-unquote dinosaur toy. You may or may not know, if you're new to the channel, you might not know, that as a child, I wasn't exactly encouraged to buy dinosaur toys. They were seen more as boy toys back in the 80s, and like, I was encouraged to buy, like, My Little Pony and Care Bears and Barbie and stuff, which, don't get me wrong, I still have those collections and I love those toys, but I really, really loved dinosaurs. I had, my imaginary friend growing up was the Tyrannosaurus Rex, as you may know, and so it was a big deal for me to get a quote-unquote dinosaur toy. And the way that I was able to get this one is I think it's a capsule toy. That's what I was told, at least by people who tried to remember where I got the thing. But it very well could have been just a cheapy toy from the dime store or whatever. But pretty sure it was a capsule toy. And whatever, however I got it packaged, it was with a bunch of other things. And so they couldn't really, like, say no to me because I got it, like, randomly. But I was super stoked to have it. As you can see, I've kept it for 30-plus years. And I really cherish this thing. And anyway, you might think it's silly, but when I saw that they were doing the Mattel Dimetrodon, I had to get one. I also have the Kenner one from G1 Jurassic Park. My husband found me one in the package, which kind of broke my heart because I couldn't do anything with it. Like, I have the complete series of dinosaurs in package, and I couldn't break it. Couldn't break the seals. I was like, there's no way I can't do this. Especially since for what they were going for at the time. At a comic show with the Jeep, back in January, I found, again, the Kenner one loose. So, like I said, I found it at the Toy Fair. This is my haul from the DeLand Comics and Collectibles show. And it wasn't very much. I think they were between 5 and 10 each. And I think, actually, what happened is I was like, how much for all of the thing? Because it was like a little, like, plastic shoebox full of Jurassic stuff. And I'm like, how much for all the Jurassic stuff? And he's like, well, since you have the Jeep, it's X amount for the whole pile or whatever. So anyway, I believe this is a Gorgonopsid. I got Alan Grant. I got this little trike, which I haven't looked up yet to see which figure that came with. I got the Pteranodon from Wave 1. And also this guy here. Now, like I said, this is my open one. I also have one sealed. But as you can see, the mechanism does still work. The chomping feature is kind of fun, and I had to have it. And just for funsies, and because I love the Papo or Papo line, I also have the Papo Dimetrodon. And I forget where I picked this up. I think it was at the Dino Store in Cocoa Beach, but don't quote me because that might be totally wrong. I might have just picked it up at a toy store. It's been a while. But I do have this one. I love the sail. I love the dynamic pose. So let's not make me wait anymore. This, of course, is the Jurassic World Dino Rivals Dimetrodon. And it does have a Savage Strike action, which is, of course, you pull the tail and it bites. Which is not unlike the Kenner Dimetrodon. Except that this one, I feel, has a much more realistic sculpt. I really love this. I love the way that they've done this. So, as you can see, it's in the packaging that we're used to for Dino Rivals. And on the back, we have our Dino Rivals card and a nice illustration of the toy with its action feature. It does have a QR code on its foot. And we also have a collection shot of the Monolophosaurus, the Styracosaurus, Stygimoloch, and the Tapejara, which is, of course, this one. So the only one out of this wave that I did not purchase, because I have a billion of them already, is Stiggy. And, of course, don't forget to dismantle the entire package after you cut out your dinosaur so that you can access the collectible Dimetrodon card. And here is the card. I think this might be a miscut because it has some very light edge on the very top. And I think that's supposed to be black all the way across the top. I'll have to look at my other cards and see. So anyway, it might be a miscut. But there we have our statistics. The strength, speed, intelligence, and damage. And this dinosaur overall has a score of 24. I love this artwork so much. I will probably scan that and print one and tack it up somewhere in my office because I love it so much. And of course the back has the Dino Rivals logo and the Jurassic World logo. As you can see, it is a miscut, but not the way that I thought it was a miscut. I thought it was supposed to be black all the way across the top. Turns out it's actually supposed to have more of a light border across the top, and this one, the light border has been cut off. So, fun. It's a miscut. My husband will enjoy that. Let's see. So we have the sideways tail motion for the chomping action, the savage strike. We have legs that can position forward and back. These also have a pivot joint so that they can pivot outward some more, which is interesting. Let's see, is that all the way in? I guess so. This one's very stiff. Have to work on that some. Might have to use the warm water trick to heat it up a little. But anyway, I believe that it would move if I could get it to. And we have this lovely yellow underside. It does stop at the tail, however. And on top, they didn't do any red on the spines that are on the back and the tail, but they have this lovely red kind of sunset pattern speckles on the sail on this one, and it's very hard to see, but there's a lot of wonderfully sculpted scaling and creases and skin folds and stuff in the flesh on the sail. In terms of sculpt, I would say it's somewhere between Kenner and Papo because it's very lizard-like. I think if I set this on the patio, my little green Anole lizards out there would freak out because it does look a lot like them in some ways. It's just really, really big. He's got nice little beefy arms. Frumpily rumple skin. He's a lot thinner. He's very gaunt on the bottom. Like, this one has a little bitty hanging down belly, and this one also has a little round hang down lizard belly. But this one, the belly's up off the ground. I'll have to look into research about Dimetrodon to see if they think it was more athletic or more slithery. I feel like this animal would be a lot more formidable to encounter than the little swingy belly ones. But, it makes me think about alligators and crocodiles because most people think that they're slow and that they drag on the ground and they don't move very well, but they can actually run about 32 miles an hour. They pick up their body on their legs and just sprint for it. So I'd be very interested to see how fast they think this animal was. Obviously the little card doesn't necessarily reflect scientific information, so I'll have to look up Dimetrodon again and read the latest research. but the coloring is great. The skin texture is good. I do see some paint flaws, like there's some red on one of the spines here, and there's some white marks on the head over here. The teeth, some of the white goes up on the lip line. The bottom one is okay, except kind of over here on the side, it spilled over a little. So, I mean, I would say that it's on par as far as paint application with the rest of the animals in the line. Not perfect, but also not really going to ruin it for me. This is hands down, though, because of my bias, one of my absolute favorite Mattel Dino Rivals toys, and one of my favorite Mattel toys in general. I just really love this thing. Now, we don't want to forget our friend, the Tapejara, or Tapejara. Does anybody really know how to say that? I'm sure the person who named it knows how to say it. But the rest of us? Nah, forget it. It is pretty, though. It's the first version of this animal that I own in any format. I don't have any other toys of this animal. Really, the only other place that I've seen this animal, besides the Jurassic World, the game app, is Ark. They have these animals in Ark, and they're decent flyers if you can catch one. In general, I don't plan to buy too many more of the flyer toys because they are awkward to display and they take up a lot of room in storage, so I hadn't really planned on getting any more, but like I said, this is the only version of this animal I have in figure format, so it's nice to have one, and I do get the collector card with it. Oh, and I misspoke earlier. The other one in this line is the Velociraptor Blue. I also didn't get that one because I have a billion of that one too. So, sorry, Blue and Stiggy. You're just going to have to not be in my card collection unless somebody gives me one because I have way too many of that toy. Again, I think this is a little bit of a miscut. Not as much border on the top of this one. But the artwork is so cool. Very dynamic. It's straight up comic book art, and I absolutely love it. I hope that they do more of this, because this would be great to have as comics or as book illustrations or any way, really, posters, whatever you got. Come at me, Mattel, because this is awesome artwork. I would really love to know the artist who did this. If anybody knows, let me know. But anyway, we have the artwork and we have the stats here. It's one of our weaker creatures, probably because of the size and because it's a flyer, but its total score is only 15. It is fast, though. It has a speed score of 7. And, of course, the back has the Dino Rivals logo and the Jurassic World logo. All right, on to the figure itself. The first thing I want to do is this. No flyer looks good with its head all twisted sideways like an owl or like it needs a visit from the exorcist. Much better like this. Absolutely beautiful animal. I love the color scheme. It's got the same level of detail that we're used to. The button is the same color as the skin, so it blends in. The mechanism works very smoothly. You can position the head left or right a little bit, and you can, of course, open and close the mouth. It's a variable position, so you can open it all the way or just halfway. It does have little bends in the back legs, so you can point them down to grab a fish or straight back for flying. However you feel like they should be positioned, you can do that. On the bottom, of course, not much paint detail, but it is, in fact, sculpted beautifully like the front. And really, the seams on the animal don't bother me at all, even though the neck is a little bit wider than the body. And there's a little bit of a shadow between the lines, but it just looks really good. And I think the main reason it does is because they've chosen such a bright color scheme for the crest. You'll also notice that the eyes are painted very well on this figure. Nice yellow eye with a little black pupil. Even has a little nostril sculpted there. And I love the little black lines. It almost looks like a butterfly wing. If you think about a monarch butterfly or a tiger moth or whatever they are. Very much reminds me of that. Before I forget, here is your Tapejara barcode or QR code. And here is your QR code for the Dimetrodon. Overall, I'm really happy with both of these figures. Like I said, the Dimetrodon's one of my favorites of the entire Mattel line and is likely to stay that way. I did actually order a second one. Not because this one was flawed, necessarily, although it does have a few paint defects, but I was seriously considering doing a custom paint job on one. So we'll see what the other one looks like when it gets here, and if it has any flaws that are worse than this one, or if it happens to be perfect, then I could always custom paint this one. But stay tuned for that, because if I do end up doing a custom paint on one of these, I will definitely show it to you when I am done. By the way, this one still works too. I'm not as fond of the design on this one, but it does work. The Gorgonopsid does not necessarily work very well. That's all the time we have for today's video. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And until next time, happy hunting.